Hey Dons,
it's Eli
and Malia. I'm back with your weekly Cathedral Catholic Television program.
We hope you guys enjoyed your 3-day week heading into break.
Eli, you know who's ready to put in the work after our short week?
Well, it's not Kentucky. They're supposed to win the championship.
It's our new transfer quarterback, Brady Palmer. Let's send it off to Gavin to learn more about him.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
What's up, Dons? It's Gavin back on CCTV. Today we have a special CC spotlight with the new starting quarterback, Brady Palmer. Brady, yeah. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, man. Thanks so much for having me.
Of course, of course. All right. So, Brady, what was it like to migrate from Saints to Cathedral, and how easy was that transition?
Yeah, so when the whole thing went down at Saints, really, our goal was to keep as much of us together as possible. We knew that we were building something pretty special. Just the young team that we had and the success that we had just in the course of 1 year. We knew that we had to keep it going. So that was really our main goal. And once we found out that Cathedral was the spot, it was kind of shocking that that's where God put us, just because, you know,
sir,
the rival school kind of welcomed us with open arms. And there really hasn't been too much drama, which I kind of expected just coming from Saints, the rival school. So it's been really smooth so far.
How long have you been playing football?
So I started playing football when I was 7 years old. I've always been a multi-sport athlete. I was, I think, 6 years old. I started playing rugby, and I really thought that rugby was going to be my main sport throughout high school. I honestly thought I was a better rugby player than football, and then I really started taking the quarterback thing seriously probably eighth grade.
Cool.
And I figured out that I really had something special in quarterback, so that's kind of where I just made the decision to go all in.
So what are you hoping to achieve on the field as a Cathedral Catholic Don?
Yeah, so ever since I got here, the main goal has been state championship. That's all.
Absolutely.
That's all I hear. State championship. And just the work ethic here opposed to my last school, there's definitely a big difference. Everyone here is bought into the program, and I feel like my role being a leader of the team, I need to bring the team together. I try not to let the transfer thing kind of ruin any relationships.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to kind of be one big community, one big team. And I feel like once we establish that, we're going to have a lot of success on the field.
Yes, sir. Right. Finally, what are some of your biggest achievements up to this point on the field?
My biggest achievement so far, just multiple D1 offers, CIF championship last year, and honestly just the relationships I've built. I've built what I think are going to be lifelong relationships with my brothers. And I'm looking to continue it here at Cathedral.
All right, all thanks to you, Brady, for coming into the studio today. Best of luck to you and the rest of the team.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Of course, of course.
Appreciate it, big dog. Future looks bright for the Dons next season.
Dons, the Math Honor Society will have their introduction ceremony on April 11th in the lecture hall during lunch. We appreciate all the service everybody has put in this year.
If you're still looking for any service opportunities, the Interact Club is meeting at lunch in CC 109 to assemble Easter baskets for orphans.
Talking about Easter baskets, it is getting a little bit warmer over spring break. Let's send it off to Seth for some more information on the weather for the upcoming week.
The weather in Cabo is sunny with a high of 72 and a low of 62.
Hey Dons, I'm here with Mr. Freis. We're going to be talking about Palm Sunday. So what is Palm Sunday?
Palm Sunday is very important because it's the moment when we as a church celebrate Jesus' triumphant entrance into Jerusalem. But it also shows this how quickly things can change, because in just a matter of moments, the crowd turns on Jesus and how he's on trial, how he suffers, and ultimately how he dies. And it sets us in motion on Holy Week.
So heading into Easter weekend, can you tell me about the events?
We enter into the three holiest days on our calendar, the sacred Triduum. We celebrate the Mass of the Lord's Supper on Holy Thursday, and we actually have the washing of the feet. Both the Eucharist and the washing of the feet point to the necessity for service in the Christian life.
And what about Good Friday?
Good Friday is a very solemn day in the church. We gather together to hear the Passion. We are reflecting on Jesus' death, and which leads us into the next day, Holy Saturday, where we celebrate the Easter Vigil in the dark of the night, and we celebrate the new life that comes to us as a church, also comes to these new ones who are newly initiated into the church fully.
What's up, Dons? It's Andres, back again with sports. Right off the bat, the boys' baseball team is coming off a 4-2 W against Steel Canyon. They currently have an 8-2 record and hope to continue this momentum throughout the season. Special shout out to our very own Eli Selgo with having the highest batting average of .444 and Vincent Van Verlo with 2 home runs. They will face Carlsbad today at 4 p.m. The track team has had an amazing record. They had a tri meet against Scripps Ranch and Point Loma with the girls being 2-0 and the boys being 1-1. Special shout out to the 2 relay teams that broke school records. For the boys, it's Vincent Adelano, Riley Leva, Ethan Ford, and Austin McCotter. For the girls, it's Scarlett Martin, Lindsay Zimmer, Christine Bickler, and Patsy Hellman. The team looks forward to going against University City at home this afternoon at 4 p.m.
Hey Dons, it's Max. Today, we're gonna be interviewing the Dons track team. So let's head straight into this. So, what is a relay race?
Okay, so the relay race, well, there's 2 relay races. There's the 4x100 and the 4x400, and that's 4 people either running 100 meters or running a whole lap around the track.
And are there any events or meets coming up?
We have the UC Track Classic on Saturday, and we recently just participated in the Sun Devil Invitational last week.
What have you accomplished this season?
In our recent meet, the 4x800 girls team got the 3rd in the nation time with 9:16, consisting of me, Patsy Hellman, Christine Bickler, and Lindsay Zimmer.
All right, well, thank you, Dons. Now, on to Andreas with sports.
Boys lacrosse currently has a 4-5 average. They regrettably lost to Santa Fe Christian 14-9, but they will look forward to playing against Westlake on the 4th. Standout players include Finn O'Reilly, Jacob Pages, and Roman Ortega. Girls lacrosse, on the other hand, has a 4-4 average, with a 1-0 in league putting them in first place. They're currently ranked 24th in the Golden State. They're looking forward to playing against Coronado tonight at 6:30. Girls softball is having an amazing season with an 8-2 record and coming off a 19-0 victory against Valhalla. Their standout players include Serenity Trice with the highest batting average and Melissa Botticelli with the highest on-base percentage. They look forward to playing against Claremont on April 10th. Exciting news, the Buddy Bowl will be April 13th from 8:30 to 11. The championship game will be during lunch on April 19th. It costs about $20 to play, but jersey mics and a t-shirt will be provided. Now let's hear from Carson about our highly decorated crew team.
What's good, Dons? It's Carson, and today we're going to talk to a few members from our very own Cathedral Catholic crew team. Let's get into it. I'm here with team captains
Lucian Strona
and
Matthew Kornitsky.
So Matthew, as team captain, what are your roles?
As a team captain, I lead a bunch of our workouts, I lead our stretching, I lead a lot of the trailer loads when we go places, and yeah, it's fun.
Awesome. Lucian, what are some of your goals for the year?
Goals? Win. But if that's not possible, to try our best and just get stronger, get bigger, get faster, most of all.
All right, sweet. Thank you, guys. I'm here with
Colin
and
Samuel Kinter.
Samuel, who are some of the standout underclassmen on the team this year?
Bill He, Bruce Ebrio, and Cade Miles.
Colin, what does a typical practice look like?
You know, we'll pull up after school at Mission Bay. We'll get all warmed up, make sure equipment is ready. We'll get in the water, get some strokes in with the boys, and then by the end of practice, we'll make sure all the equipment's put away again, and then that we're ready to go for the next day of practice.
I'm here with
Diego Sanchez
and
Noah Levy.
Noah, how do you keep team morale up?
Some of us are averaging like 6 to 8 hours on Brawl Stars. With that, we're always pulling up to the Shell station before and after practice. And at races, we're always playing spike ball, 5 flags up.
Diego, what does the race schedule look like for the next month?
In April, we go to San Fran for our regionals, and then we go to Jersey, about to blow New Jersey up, in May for nationals.
Sweet, sounds good. Thank you, boys, for the interview. Now back in the studio.
Hey, Dons!
It's Sophia.
And Skylar.
Back with Social.
Easter's right around the corner, so we wanted to do one of everyone's favorite tradition, an Easter egg hunt.
For our teams, we have NHS, ASB, Campusmen, and CCTV.
Let's go meet the contestants.
Mary.
Gavin. CCTV.
My name's Addie Marquand, and I'm representing NHS.
I'm Beck.
I'm Sophia, and we're representing ASB.
Let Gavin get everything!
Gavin!
Where are the eggs? Don't wait for me! Wait, where are they?
This is literally a pop.
I'm in the bushes right now. I cannot find eggs. Yes! I got one!
No way!
Woohoo! I'm at 6.
I don't know where to go.
Do you see one? This is harder than I expected. Being all alone, all by my NHS, only have one egg. I need to get more. Fortunately, I only collected one egg. I'm sorry to let NHS down, but if I'm gonna be real, I only had one people. All these people had partners. I was all by myself. I have singular egg, and it's what's on the inside that matters, and it's jelly beans.
Well, basically, because it's like our own game as CCTVers, we decided to take to the defeat this round.
Yeah, we felt bad.
Yeah, ASB took a tumble with the pumpkin carving.
100%.
So we gave them this one, and
we had to be nice to them.
Yeah, congratulations, ASB.
We're not salty at all.
Mary, Gavin, we all know that's cap.
Come on, bro, letting us down?
Well, Dons, that's a wrap for this episode.
We hope everyone has a safe and blessed break, wherever it may be.
We will see you next time on another episode of CCTV.